great performance by our guys. In a tough place, they played a tough team to play against. A team that rarely wins in this place, rarely loses in this place. And I just thought our guys did a great job of battling, keeping our composure. Went to our 1-3-1 defense and probably did it at the right time. They did a great job early in the second half, putting their head down, getting to the basket, making plays. So we pulled it out at the right time. Good thing I pulled it out the first half. So, but just a really good performance by our guys. I mean, rarely do you play games at this level on the road against a quality opponent of this magnitude and coaching staff and to win like this. But guys did a tremendous job from top to bottom, did a tremendous job in handling their press. Because the last 2 years, I thought we lost the game against their press here. Just couldn't handle the pressure, turn the ball over late. 5 turnovers against a team like this against the press, great job.
Coach, can you talk a little bit about that zone look? It's something that hadn't seen yet this season. Kind of where did they've been working on it, and what made you decide to pull it out?
We've actually been working on zone offense, and we put a zone defense, and we do that the first week of practice. But I'm just really not a big fan of a 2-3 zone. We do it more so if we need it, and also when we go against it. So we work on a zone 2-3 every day. So that's something we always do.
What made it, I guess?
I think, you know, just going against the 1-3-1, I just felt like I've been looking for something to change up for our guys. And I feel like with the 1-3-1, you can't make a direct pass. You know, against the 2-3 zone, whether you got great shooters or not, you still can make passes. You can find guys. It might be tough maybe to get in the post, depending on what their emphasis is with their zone defense. But with a 1-3-1, there are not many direct passes. You got to go over the top. And I'm thinking, you know, probably threw those guys off. That's probably the last thing they were expecting.
What about shooting like this on the road tonight from 3-point range?
Well, like I told our guys, you got to take shots. We felt like they probably played a zone most of the night. When the shots present themselves, you got to take shots. You miss them, you miss them. And I go back to the, and I don't want to harp on it, but I go back to the Florida game. It was just a game. We didn't play well, but it wasn't the case for me. Like, oh man, what happened? I knew our guys could shoot better. We just didn't play well as a team. Got off to a slow start, never bounced back. But the last game of Ole Miss, we shot it well. Tonight, I thought our guys shot the three well. When they present themselves, knock them down, because you got to allow that thing to open up for our big guys to play.
Because I know maybe the numbers won't reflect that, but Darius kind of this environment and
great job.
Being a point guard had to be pretty pleased with him.
And one thing about it, you never know if he's afraid, rattled, confident. You just don't know because his demeanor never changes. But you're talking about a guy almost 6'5 at the point guard position when you press him. And we spend so much time with him. With a guy like Relif, who's quick and strong, a guy didn't get under him. But he's done a great job really working with Coach Webster, individual skill, but also working with his team, backing up, pulling the dribble, keeping it alive, then making decisions. I thought our guys did a great job of helping him find the right guys and maybe come to get the ball. I thought AJ did a great job of coming to get the press. He's a guy who, you know, really always played on the perimeter all his life. And I thought he did a great job of flashing, getting that ball. He doesn't mind dribbling the ball as well.
When y'all weren't struggling, you get those big leads early in the season. Some of those games would kind of get closer, and to control it like this a couple games in a row now, I mean, it never got to,
The thing we talk about is the team was focused. And I said earlier in the year, even though we have some experienced guys, it's not like we have an experienced team that's been together for a long time across the board with 5, 6, 7, 8 guys. So I think more or less we find our way as a team. We're getting better. We're talking about Jerome Engel, 15, 18 months removed. Darius, a true freshman. Antonio Boyd, that's been with our program. And I just think we're getting better as a team, playing with confidence. And again, to win a game like this against this caliber opponent is big for us.
Good week for you, wasn't it?
Really good week. Really good week. And I told our guys, it's the first time I've ever shaken all those guys' hands. I mean, you know what I'm saying? A lot of different things. But I actually shake the hands after the game and just really thank them for their effort. Because a lot of times we say thank you, we take it for granted. But I just want to thank those guys for their effort and their approach and mental focus. And they deserve it. They did a great job in preparation. We might do a lot of 13. We call it that 1-3-1. They like that. You know, Jordan can stand around a little bit.
Your thoughts on John L's performance tonight? I mean, I think you guys had 2 shots.
Well, he's been playing well. Sure. This is just another night. But he's been playing really well. But his whole approach, and I've said it before, whenever he plays with an aggressive mindset, we're a different team. He's a different player. If he keeps that, we're at another level when he does that. Man's the ball, he's aggressive, he's assertive, he's a good ball player. But I just think his mindset has changed from the standpoint one of the better bigs in all of college basketball, and that's his approach.
There's a play we caught.